Okay. Next question. I'm going to give you only a minute and a half for this.
Okay, sir. Sir, ready. Got the answer.
Okay, when you got the answer, type it in. Type it
It.
in. Right, everyone says C. Okay, simple. So we have the temperature on Monday. -8 degrees. Now, is -8 degrees sunny or do we see snowflakes?
Snoopy.
Snowy, right?
Snowing.
Right. Tuesday it is -4 degrees. Now, is -8 colder or is it -4?
-8 is colder than -4.
Are you able to imagine the number line?
Yeah, sir.
Right. Now we also have Wednesday. Wednesday it says 8 degrees, that is +8 degrees. That means, is it do we see snowflakes?
No,
All right.
sir.
Now what is the question? Which is the coldest day among the three?
Monday.
Right. Monday is the coldest. And which is the hottest day?
Wednesday. Wednesday.
Perfect. Easy. Great. Next. Read the question. I think it's clear. Be very careful with how the number line has been divided. There's a difference of 5 between two of the numbers. 35 and 40 has 5 lines. Sorry, it'll have 4 lines, obviously. 36, 37, 38, 39. Similarly for all of them. Observe very carefully and answer. 2 minutes, guys.
Sir, do we have to write all of the answers on the chat? Sir?
Can you guys hear me?
Yes, sir. Sir, we have to
Yeah.
write all of the answers in the chat or
Yeah,
can we
one,
send this?
two, three. One, two, three.
Okay.
Put in the chat. A minute and a half should be enough for this. One second, my video got turned off. Put in the answers for two and three. One is not needed. Put in the answers for two and three. Guys.
Sir,
Yes.
the third question that the last sentence, Nandital and Srinagar together, the temperature together add up.
Which one?
The third one that 2 points are there, right? Can we say temperature of nation is more than the temperature of Nandital and Srinagar? That means together, Nandital and Srinagar, their temperature has both been added up, right?
Obviously, together means adding, right?
Okay.
30 seconds, guys. 30 seconds.
So can I put like three answer like that, right?
Okay. Part one says observe the number line and write the temperature of the cities marked on it. All right. Panitop should be -9.
Sir, you told us not to do this one.
No, I'm just putting it because this was observation based. Two and three were calculation based. That's the reason I asked you guys to do two and three. But you obviously need to know
Sir,
the answers to one, right?
that mine I give third one first wrong because I thought it is four and it was my.
I understood. I understood. Yeah, you put three as a yes. Don't worry. All right. So what is Srinagar? Srinagar is -4. All right. Now, Nainital is how much? Six. All right. What is Shimla? Seven. Are you able to follow? Bhubaneswar, 21. Varanasi, 32. Chennai, 39. All these are in degrees Celsius, assuming. All right. Everyone's following? Okay, this is done. Now, what does he say? What is the difference of temperature between the hottest and the coldest places? Which is the hottest place?
Sir, the hottest place is
Chennai.
Bhubaneswar.
Chennai.
Bhubaneswar.
My calculation problem. That knocking down feeling.
Okay, the hottest is Chennai. What is the coldest? It is obviously Pune. How
Sir, coldest.
Srinagar the coldest? Is -9 colder or -4 colder?
-9.
So isn't it Patnitop?
Yes, sir, it's Patnitop.
Right. So what is the hottest? It is Chennai. Okay. And what is the coldest? It's Patnitop. What is the difference between 39 and -9?
Sir, so minus become plus, right?
Exactly, because from 39 we move to 0, or either way around, from -9 we go to 0.
48.
Exactly. That is what I was trying to say. Is everyone clear? Is everyone clear with this? From -9 we move till 0, then from 0 we move another 39. He's talking about the entire difference of those two points on the number line, plus 39 and minus 9. Is everyone clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, perfect. Now, what is the third one? Can we say that the temperature of Bhubaneswar, what is the temperature of Bhubaneswar? Plus 21 degrees Celsius. That means it is hot. Is it more than the temperature of Nainital and Srinagar? What is the temperature of what is the temperature of Nainital? It is plus 6. What is the temperature of Srinagar? It is minus 4. Now, if I add both of them, what am I going to get? Now, is 21 greater than the temperature of Nainital and Srinagar together?
Yes.
Obviously, yes, because Bhubaneswar is 21 degrees, right? So, can we say this is true? Yes, we can say so. Are we clear with the question?
Sir, can you tell me who the third question's logic? I didn't get that. Please repeat.
Okay.
Sir, can you please tell me the second question's answer?
Second question is 48.
Okay.
39 minus of minus 9, because from we started counting from minus 9 and moved till plus 39. How many gaps do we have? 48 in between.
Okay.
Because from minus 9 to 0 you move 9 units. From 0 to 39 you move another 39 units. So what is the total movement? 48.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, one second. Yes, can you hear me? Are you able to see me also?
Yes,
Okay, I don't know what I think there's
definitely,
some
yes.
network issue. All right, cool. Yeah. So where's the doubt? Do we have a doubt in the third part? Can we say that the
Yeah.
temperature? Okay. So what's the temperature of Bhubaneswar? 21 degrees. Now, what is the temperature of Nainital and Srinagar? Nainital is 6 degrees. That means it is way colder than Bhubaneswar. The temperature is way lesser. What is the temperature of Srinagar? It is even lesser, minus 4. Now, isn't Bhubaneswar naturally cold, hotter than Nainital and Srinagar combined?
Yeah.
That is what he's asking. Can we say that temperature Bhubaneswar is more means if the temperature is more, that means Bhubaneswar is hotter as compared to Nainital and Srinagar together. What if
I
you
think
say that the temperature is lesser? What is he trying to say? Is he talking about hotter or colder if he's talking about a lesser temperature?
lesser temperature means it is like colder.
Yes, exactly. That is what he's trying to tell.
Okay,
One second. this. Yeah, let's do this question then. Let me pick the good ones before we're running out of time. Can you see the screen in a
yes,
class?
Sir.
Yeah. We have one more question after this. Let's see if time permits. Giving you guys 2 minutes for this.
Sir, what is the total mark?
We don't know. That is not needed. If I give a correct answer, I'm going to get a +3. If I'm going to give a wrong answer, I'm going to get a -2. If I do not attempt, there is no plus, no minus. It stays at 0. He is telling that he has scored 20 marks out of n number of marks. We do not have to worry about that. But he's saying he got 12 correct answers. They're two individual questions. You'll get two different answers, 1 and 2. One 8 and 2 13 is what Vamika says. Okay, let's see. 1 8 is correct. 2 3 recheck Vamika. 8 is correct. 3 isn't.
I was saying that 2, I mean 3 is the answer of the question number 2.
No, it isn't. 8 is the answer for the first question. 3 isn't the answer for question number 2. Recheck.
But I'm also a bit confused about this.
Read it again, recheck. If you got the first one right, you should be getting the second one also. Another minute, guys.
Sir.
Yes, Neha.
The first one is at 8.
It is 8, correct. What's the second one?
But 2. 2 is the second one.
Okay, Vamika says 2. Okay, chal, let's discuss. Let's discuss the first one.
So, second one, 2.
He scored. Ram got 20 marks. It is given that he gave 12 correct answers. Each correct answer is giving me 3 marks. So 12 correct answers should technically give me 36 marks. Now, if he would have answered 12 correctly, picked 12, answered 12 and left, he would have got 36 marks. But how many did he actually get? He got 20 marks only. How many marks did he lose? 16 marks?
Yeah.
All of you agree with me? How many marks did he lose? Marks lost. 16 marks. That means if he has lost marks, that means he has answered them incorrectly. You guys agree with me?
Yeah.
One incorrect is costing him how many marks? -2. You guys agree with me? The loss of 2 marks. If he has lost 16 marks, that means how many questions did he answer incorrectly? 8 questions. Incorrect. You guys agree with me?
Yeah.
That is what he's asking us. If he would have answered 12 correct and left, he would have got 36 marks because each correct answer is fetching him 3. Instead of 36, he got only 20. That means he lost 16 marks. How did he lose? Because there is negative marking. For each question that he answers incorrectly, he is losing 2 marks. If he is losing 16 marks, that means he has answered 8 questions incorrectly. That is what he's trying to ask. How many questions did he attempt incorrectly? The answer is 8. Are we clear with the first one?
Yeah.
Great. Now, second one. There's this guy called Mohan. He got negative. -5 marks was his total. But he says he had given 7 correct answers. That means if he has given 7 correct, how many should he have got 7 into 3? each break after fetching him 12-3 marks?
Yeah, he should have got 14 marks if he didn't get any wrong answer.
One second. He should have got 21 marks. Each correct is giving him 3. Plus 3 for every correct. Minus 2 for every incorrect. Right? Same logic. The common information isn't changing. If he has given 7 correct, that means he should get 21 marks. Instead of getting plus 21, that guy ended up with minus 5. That means from this 21, he lost his 21 marks, came to a score of 0 marks. In addition to this, he lost another 5 marks. You guys understand what I'm trying to say? I answered 7 correct. I got 21 marks. From 21, what happened is, I actually got minus 5. From plus 21, if I have to move to minus 5 on the number line, if this is 0, if this is plus 21, and if I have to move to minus 5, how much is the reduction? From 21 to 0, it is a reduction of 21. From 0 to 5, it is another reduction of 5. That means how many marks did he lose in total? 26 marks he lost. You guys agree with me?
Yeah.
In order to lose 26 marks, how many answers did he give incorrectly? If each incorrect answer is giving him minus 2. One wrong is giving him minus 2. How many did he answer wrong to get a minus 26?
13.
26 by 2, right? Check your calculation now. Are you clear? That means he gave 13 wrong answers. Because of which, from plus 21, that is, even though he gave 7 correct, he moved down 26 marks to arrive at minus 5. That means he gave 13 wrong answers. Are you guys clear with this?
So can you please show me the calculation?
Okay. Even more than the calculation, imagine the number line. I got plus 21. I was in a good position. But my final score says minus 5 marks. That means from 21, I first have to lose 21 marks to get to 0. I did not even get 0 on my test or my exam. I got minus 5. That means I lost another 5 marks. So how many marks did I lose in total? 26 marks have been lost. So for one wrong answer, 2 marks are lost. Minus 2 marks. For minus 26 marks, how many should he have answered incorrectly? This is the same as the speed and distance wala question, the first one that we did. Yeah, can you do the calculation here? For every wrong, if he is losing 2 marks, if he has lost 26
yes, sir.
Marks, how many mistakes did he make? How many mistakes did he make?
Maybe 20, okay. 26 divided by
2 minus 26 by minus 2.
Hello, sir.
Minus 26 divided by minus 2.
Yeah.
That's how we arrived at 13 incorrect answers. Are we clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. Now let's look at this last question. We're already.
Sir, can I leave because I have to go somewhere?
Okay, all right, Vamika. The others, try this. I'm giving you a minute and a half. Very easy. Giving you a minute and a half to do this. Quick. Pragya, Riddhima, Neha. Do you have an answer?
Time so, up. Wait a minute. I'm getting the answer.
Okay.
So, can I answer?
Yes, Neha.
So, is it minus 14 degrees Celsius?
Okay, and there are two questions in this. Minus 14 is the correct answer to one question. What is the other question? Okay, let's see. 12 noon.
Sir, actually what happened is I thought one question is there and I only work out one question.
Read the question carefully. He says at 12 p.m. it was 10 degrees Celsius above zero, right? Now, this is the first part. At what time is the temperature 8 degrees below zero? 8 degrees below zero means you have to go to minus 8 degrees. given that it decreases at the rate of 2 degrees Celsius. That means if every hour it is decreasing by 2 degrees, you can either plot it on a number line and imagine it, or you can either do it directly. So 12 p.m. if it's 10 degrees Celsius, what is after 12? It is 1 p.m., 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So if it is decreasing by 2 every time, it's becoming 8, 2, 4, 2, 0. Yes?
So is it 12 minus 24?
12 minus 24. No, wait, follow what I'm doing. All this time is in PM, that is after 12 noon. So every hour, the temperature is decreasing by 2 degrees. So 6 PM, it's minus 2, 7 PM, it is minus 4, 8 PM, it is minus 6, and 9 PM, it is minus 8. This is the first question. At what time will the temperature be 8 degrees below 0 degrees Celsius? The answer is 9 PM. Now, what is the second part? If it decreases at the rate of 2 degrees Celsius per hour till midnight, what will be the temperature at midnight? He's saying continue this. He is going to decrease by 2 degrees every hour. So after 9, it is 10 p.m. He's talking about midnight. So we have 11 p.m. and then we have 12 a.m. From minus 8, it is going to become minus 10. Another 2 degrees is going to be minus 12. Another 2 degrees is going to be minus 14. That is, at midnight, the temperature is going to be minus 14 degrees Celsius. Do you now see the two parts to the question? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Yeah.
Are you clear with all the concepts in the session?
Yes, sir, it's clear.
Okay, great. Let's end the session here. Did you enjoy the questions?
Yes, sir, I really enjoyed the questions.
Okay. I hope there are no doubts with respect to the concepts.
No
doubt, sir.
Okay, great. Chalo. Thank you, guys. Good night.
Okay, bye, sir. Have a nice